happen. There it goes again.
Yeah, if it happens two more times, it's not gonna be coming back on.
What?
Yeah, that's a recloser. We talk about that at work all the time. It opens and closes automatically four times to try to clear a temporary fault in the line so that the crew doesn't have to come out and fix it. Oh, there's three. Oh, there's four. Looks like we're gonna be sitting in the dark for a while. Must have been a permanent fault.
Well, I'm glad you predicted we're gonna be sitting in the dark for a while.
65 to 90% of faults on utility power systems are temporary faults, like lightning or animal contact. Utilities use automatic circuit breakers called reclosers to clear these temporary faults, so they don't have to roll a truck to fix the problem. When a fault occurs on an electrical system, protective devices like fuses and circuit breakers are used to remove the excessive fault current to minimize the damage to the electrical system. A recloser is essentially a circuit breaker that takes advantage of its capability to reset itself in case the fault is a temporary one. Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, you can see examples of reclosers in operation and see what options are included to maximize the benefits of using modern reclosers.
So what is a recloser and how does it work? A recloser is a self-controlled device for automatically interrupting and reclosing an alternating current circuit, with a predetermined sequence of opening and reclosing, followed by resetting or lockout operation. It includes an assembly of control elements required to detect overcurrents and control the recloser operation. Two main categories are hydraulic and electronic reclosers. Here is a typical sequence for a recloser operation. Once the fault occurs, the recloser opens quickly. This is called a fast or instantaneous operation. It quickly removes the fault to try to minimize permanent disruption to the circuit. After a short delay, power is restored. Once the recloser has closed back in and the fault persists, it will typically open again for a second fast operation. If the fault is still present, there is typically a short delay where the power is off and then comes back on for a slightly longer period of time. The intention of this slow operation is to coordinate with protective devices like fuses if the fault is downstream of those devices. If a downstream fuse blows, power is restored and the rest of the system returns to normal. The only feeder downstream of the fuse is out of service. If the recloser senses the fault during a subsequent fourth attempt to clear the fault, and if no downstream device has cleared the fault, the recloser locks out and requires manual intervention as there is a permanent fault on the system. The combination of fast and slow operations is programmable and selected based on utility standards. For example, some utilities use one fast and two slow, but the most common combination is two fast and two slow operations.
The first reclosers were invented just prior to World War II and used transformer oil and some mechanical components. Plungers and pistons use hydraulic action to control timing and number of operations. This is a modern single-phase hydraulic recloser still in use today on many rural feeders across the country. Here is what the inside of a recloser looks like with a glass case so that you can see the operation of the mechanism within the oil. This trip piston must fully reset before the recloser can go back to its normal operation. Otherwise, the recloser will lock out sooner than it would have during normal operation. Inside the recloser, there's a piston that allows you to select the number and type of operations. Most modern three-phase circuits and some single-phase circuits are protected by electronic reclosers. An electronic recloser like this one uses vacuum bottles to interrupt fault current. The electronic controls at the base of the structure or pole-mounted recloser controls all of the operation and protective settings for coordinating with downstream devices. This electronic control unit can also be programmed to operate as a sectionalizer or a device that removes part of a system during a permanent fault scenario. Electronic reclosers also have communication modules so that the remote operators and automatic controls from SCADA systems can open or close the recloser or use it to reconfigure the system as necessary. This electronic recloser is called a three-phase recloser as it will open all three phases for a fault on any of the phases. This is called a triple single, which can operate all of the phases together as a three-phase recloser or operate each phase independently for single-phase fault conditions. This single-phase electronic recloser uses a vacuum bottle and electronic control that allows it to operate similar to a three-phase recloser. This demonstration illustrates how reclosers operate for various temporary and permanent fault conditions on a power system. This PLC is programmed to demonstrate how this hydraulic recloser and sectionalizer would operate on a real system and coordinate with downstream fused cutouts. For this scenario, we will place a fault downstream of this fused cutout. The recloser opens twice during its fast operation in case the fault was temporary. Then during its first slow operation, it coordinates with the fused cutout. Once the fault is cleared, after the fuse blows, the system goes back to normal and only the small section connected to the fuse is lost. Once the fuse is replaced, the system goes back to normal. As you can see, we could do many other demonstrations with this same simulator.
Simulations are one thing, but it's important to be able to show how a real recloser works on a full-scale system. Here at the PSEC, we've developed a full-scale power distribution system to simulate faults on a power line, and we show how protective devices like reclosers can clear the faults. In this scenario, we have four reclosers that will come into play. This one-line diagram shows how power feeds the critical load of the hospital from this white feeder. During the fault condition, watch as the system reconfigures itself after this permanent fault and the hospital is fed from the blue feeder. Okay, here we go. The tree falls on the power line, the substation recloser on the white feeder clears the fault still persists so the recloser clears the fault again, the fault still exists so the recloser switches to a slow operation with the hopes that a downstream fuse clears the fault. Since the fault is still present during the final slow operation, the fault is considered permanent and the recloser at the substation opens up and locks out. This recloser downstream of the tree locks out, isolating the fault, and this recloser reconnects the loop system at this point, backfeeding our critical load to the hospital. Once the tree is cut away from the line, the system can be reset to normal without disruption to the load. With feeder automation software, monitoring and reconfiguring the system, critical loads can be restored quickly during permanent fault conditions. Reclosers are used as sectionalizers to open parts of the circuit during permanent fault conditions and rearrange as necessary. In one recent example, during a major hurricane on the East Coast, 5 million customers lost power, but 1 million of those customers had power restored without sending a line crew. The feeder automation system reconfigured the system automatically and with some manual intervention to optimize the power system, minimized outages to customers. Reclosers played an important role in that power restoration effort. Reclosers also have the capability to reduce arc flash levels on a medium voltage power system via this hotline tag switch. With this switch engaged, the recloser is set for one operation with software settings set to minimum delay. It can open a circuit breaker in about 40 milliseconds or the mechanical time of the device. This is a huge benefit for large industrial or utility companies that have to do hotline work. The reduction in clearing time during arc faults can reduce arc flash levels from much higher than 40 calories per centimeter squared to less than 5 calories. Today's modern electronic reclosers can also include voltage sensing. This enables utilities to monitor and control power flow on the system and protect customers from single phase situations.
I thought you said we were sitting in the dark for a while because your recloser locked out.
Yeah, but fortunately, it looks like the utility must have been using a feeder automation system to be able to reconfigure the power to get it to us from a different source.
That works, whatever it takes.
Reclosers play a vital role in minimizing downtime for utility customers. Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, you can see live demonstrations of reclosers in action. To learn more about reclosers and feeder automation, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.